Y'all, we back at it with another reaction. We got another Kendrick diss. This nigga done hit him with the combo. It's crazy. Like, one wasn't enough, you know? He not waiting for a response. He said, fuck all that shit. This nigga finna hear what I got to say. Real nigga shit. I can't lie. K-Dot, he won first round. I can't lie. Like, you gotta go back and listen to it if you don't believe so. Like, you gotta really break it down and shit. You feel me? I feel like a lot of it, I ain't gonna lie, a lot of it went over my head the first time. But after I actually sat down and thought about the bars and re-listened to it and everything, it's like, no, you know, hands down, bro. First of all, it's 6 minutes long of just straight content, you know? Like, yeah. Drake had the whole, like, melody and shit going on, repeated some of it, so it's like he had a hook. So, but K-Dot's, his was certified, y'all can't lie. And he touched on everything. He did recycle a lot of shit that, like, other people who dissed Drake said, but it's like he said a lot of shit too, different takes and shit on it. So I'm excited to see what he bring with this one. This one's 3 minutes 44. 6:16 in LA, Drake diss. Kind of nervous, y'all, I ain't gonna lie, but let's get it. Bro, first of all, okay, we 7 seconds in, ain't shit happened, but I wanted to say, like, bro, where is J. Cole, bro? That nigga must have got, like, raptured or some shit. Because I ain't seen him. I ain't heard about him. That man is gone. Literally. Like, that shit's crazy. He really left Drake alone. That's what I'm saying. Like, why is Drake... Where is Drake's people that say, like, you know, that's fuck rocking with Drake? Like, where is that? Where are they? Drake all alone for real. Like, y'all gotta come help your boy. Get your mans.
Yeah. It's survival. Survival. I think somebody lying. Smell somebody lying. I don't see no fire.
Man, he keep me talking about niggas lying. He said in the last one, like, don't lie about me and I won't tell the truth about you. Call that man a master manipulator. That man a habitual liar. Like...
Off-white sun seeker at the marina. Fuck a phantom. I like to buy yachts when I get the fever. Wine cool.
See, this is what I like, bro. At the beginning of that other one, I was like, what the fuck is this? I mean, it was cool and chill, but this is what I expected. For real, like, off-rip Kendrick, like, you can hear the aggression and shit in his voice. Like, he wants the smoke. For real.
Off-white sun seeker at the marina. Fuck a phantom, I like to buy yachts when I get the fever. Wine cooler spill on my white t-shirt, the sightseer. Trifecta, money, morals, and culture. That's my leisure, my visa. Passport tatted, I show up in Ibiza. Luke Cali's dwellings in Brooklyn just to book me some pizza. Who can reach us? Only God can teleport this type of freedom. God, my confession is yours. But who am I if I don't go to war? There's opportunity when living with loss. I discover myself when not far short. Raise my hands to a falling sky. I fantasize me jumping planets immortalized. I correspond. Three angels watching me.
Why is my space working? Okay. There's opportunity when you take a loss.
For sure, raise my hands to a fallen sky. I fantasize me jumping planets immortalized. I correspond. Three angels watching me all the time. Put my children to sleep with a prayer, then close my eyes. Definition of peace. Tell me who gon' stop me. I come from love and still cover my heart. T-shirt, the sightseer. Trifecta, money, morals, and culture. That's my leisure, my visa. Passport tatted, I show up in Ibiza. Luke Cali's dwellings in Brooklyn just to book me some pizza. Who can reach us? Only God can teleport this type of freedom. God, my confession.
profession is yours. But who am I if I don't go to war? There's opportunity when living with loss. I discover myself would not fall short. Raise my hands to a fallen sky. I fantasize me jumping planets immortalized. I correspond. Three angels watching me all the time. Put my children to sleep with a prayer, then close my eyes. Definition of peace. Tell me who gon' stop me. I come from love and still cover my heart, then open me up. Remember when picked up a pen, lyrics that I can trust. Timid soul staring in the mirror, asking where I was from often. I know this type of power is gon' cost, but I live in circadian rhythms of a shooting star. The mannerisms of Raphael, I can heal and give you art, but the industry's cooked as I pick the carcass apart. Yeah, somebody's lying, I can see the vibes on act. Even he looking compromised, let's peel the layers back. Ain't no brownie points will be in your chest, harassing ant. Fucking with good people make good people go to bed. Conspiracies about
facts. You know what they say, pain turns birds into vultures. Like, y'all keep hurting good people and expect them to just keep being good. Like, where in science, math, history does that seem right? You can't just keep doing bad, good people bad and think they just gonna stay good. Like, where does that make sense to y'all, that, bruh? Where in world, in the world, in life, where, nigga? Where does it say that that's right or that's how it's gonna go? Nowhere. Y'all gonna keep pushing us, but like, y'all don't even know, bruh. The good people are the ones that got the most to be bad for real. Because it's hard to be good. It's easy to go do bad shit and do what you want to and not think about nobody else. You gotta be really conscious and be able to self-reflect and know yourself to actually be able to do good and push forward and shit. Like, people don't understand, don't know nothing about that.
Give you art, but the industry's cooked as I pick the carcass apart. Yeah, somebody's lying, I can see the vibes on act. Even he looking compromised, let's peel the layers back. Ain't no brownie points will be in your chest, harassing ant. Fucking with good people make good people go to bed. Conspiracies about cash, dog, that's not even the leak. Find the jewels like cash, dog, I just need you to think. Are you finally ready to play? Have you ever, let's see, have you ever thought that OVO is working for me? Fake bully, I hate bullies, you must be a terrible person. Everyone inside your team is whispering that you deserve it. Can't tussy slide about it. This one is just gonna resurface. Every dog gotta have his day. Now live in your purpose. It was fun until you start to put money.
Dang. Said, have you ever played? You know? Like, he said that in the last one too. He said, every nigga on your team is really whispering, thinking you deserve it. That's crazy.
Need you to think. Are you finally ready to play? Have you ever, let's see, have you ever thought that OVO is working for me? Fake bully, I hate bullies, you must be a terrible person. Everyone inside your team is whispering that you deserve it. Can't tussy slide about it. This one is just gonna resurface. Every dog gotta have his day. Now live in your purpose. It was fun until you start to put money in the streets, then lost money because they came back with no receipts. I'm sorry that I live a boring life. I love peace, but war ready if the world is ready to see you bleed. The Elohim.
That's a bar caption.
Cause they came back with no receipts. I'm sorry that I live a boring life. I love peace, but war ready if the world is ready to see you bleed. The Elohim KTW. Ooh. No, you can't sleep. These images trouble you. Know the why.
I love my boring life. I love peace. But no, I'm war ready. If they ever ready to see you bleed, my boy. K-Dot spitting.
In your circle should puzzle you. If you were street smart, then you would have caught that your entourage is only to hustle you. 100 that you got on salary, and 20 of them want you as a casualty, and one of them is actually next to you, and two of them is practically tired of your lifestyle, just don't got the audacity to tell you. But let me tell you some game, because I can see
who is. Oh my god, nah. Okay, now you ain't had to do them. This is what I was waiting for, the first one, bro. This is gonna hurt Drake's chest. His chest gonna be hurting for like a week.
To puzzle you. If you were street smart, then you would have caught that your entourage is only to hustle you. 100 niggas that you got on salary, and 20
hover want you as a casualty. And one of them is actually next to you, and two of them is practically tired of your lifestyle. Just don't got the audacity to tell you, but let me tell you some game, cause I can see you, my little homie. You playing dirty with propaganda, hit blow up on you. You're playing nerdy with Zach Beer and Twitter bots, but your reality can't hide behind Wi-Fi. Your little means is losing steam, they figured you out. The forced opinions is not convincing, y'all need a new route. It's time that you look around on who's around you. Before you figure that you're not alone, ask what Mike would do.
He really little homie in this nigga, bro. He is son in this nigga. That's disrespectful. That's disrespectful. But no, honestly, it might be some good advice that Drake needs to take. You know, sometimes it's your worst enemies that can give you the best advice. You know what I'm saying? And I'm like, that's just coming from, like, me, personally. Like, it's true, though, because they know all your flaws. They know they gonna pick, like, nitpick all of your flaws. And they can tell you everything that's wrong with you, everything, how you move and everything, bro. So if your enemy try to sit you down or, like, throw you some shit, actually, like, think about that shit, bro. Because your enemies, they can give you the best advice. That's a fact. They know all your weaknesses, like, and strengths. That's crazy. I know K-Dot and Drake, they weren't always, you know, frenemies, I guess, but I'm just saying, you know, that makes it even better, though, because if K-Dot actually has some good, like, third eye view perspective to actually help Drake, because I feel like, I don't know, I really don't be getting into Drake's life like that, but I know, like, in everybody's circle, it could be cleaned up. That's a fact. Everybody could cut their grass. You know what I'm saying? That's a fact. So y'all, it's always good to, you know, stay on the lookout, look around you, make sure you know who you're hanging out with, who you're around, and don't be letting no fuck shit happen, bro. Cause it only takes one time, for real, and you're just gonna be different forever. Especially a nigga like Drake. That's what I'm saying. Like these famous people. They don't be checking who's in their circle. They just be trusting anybody. Like, that's stupid. Or, like, just because they can offer you something, you're going to give them this. It's like, nah. You got to be real selective about who you let in your circle. And not even, like, your immediate circle, who you hang with every day. I'm talking about, like, business, too. Like, who you doing business with? Do they do square business? Like, you got to make sure. Anyways, why did I start talking about shapes, circles, and squares and shit? Like, I don't fucking know, but y'all know what I'm trying to say. But anyways, I hope y'all enjoyed the video. Y'all go check out motherfreaking Kayla. I'm ready for Drake to react or respond. I don't know. He might cry. I can't lie, y'all. I love my nigga Drake. I ain't gonna lie. I listen to Drake all the time. But this is bullying. This is cyberbullying. For real. Like, he dropped two back-to-back. That's disrespectful. He ain't even waiting for him to respond. He's like, nah, you getting this. Everybody gonna hear the second one. Drake probably started writing, like, the first little lines. And then this bitch dropped. And he's like, oh, fuck. Throw it all away. But nah, y'all. I'm excited to see where this is going. If Drake doesn't respond, I feel like that'd be kind of lame. Because that's what J. Cole already, like, J. Cole, like, bro. That nigga already tapped out. That nigga didn't even wait for it to start, honestly. Which I get. Y'all see my video. If you didn't, y'all go check it out. I made an hour-long video. Because I'm a big fan, very passionate about shit like this. About J. Cole's little, you know, thing. But we ain't gonna talk about it. If y'all want to go watch that video, y'all can. But shit, yeah. I just hope, I don't know. K-Dot sound, He want to smoke for real. Maybe even in real life. But I ain't gonna make it that. I ain't gonna, like, I love Drake, K-Dot. Like, I definitely listen to both of them on a daily basis. So, I ain't picking sides. I refuse. But I love hearing these niggas at their A-game. They are giving it all they got on these tracks, bro. And that's what I'm here for. As a fan, you know. And I'm trying to keep hearing them make music. I don't want nothing to happen to them, for real. So I hope they keep it friendly competition and see what y'all got, for real. We both know y'all can bring it, too. Like, y'all are both at the top of the game. Like, we can't lie. We can't sit here and lie. But, yeah, I'm happy to see where it goes. I hope y'all enjoyed the video. If you did, give it a like. If you're gonna stick around, stay tuned, subscribe for more. I really appreciate all the love and support.